sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
I heard somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are at Bill Stadium in upstate New York. The folks in Buffalo love their Bills, and a moment ago they entered to the delight of this sold-out crowd. They're set for football as their Bills will do battle with Derek Carr and the Las Vegas Raiders. And we are underway in Buffalo. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Jacobs. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
What now?
Running it with Jacobs, and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Really good stop there by the end in this 4-3 defense.
And not just pass rushers anymore, are they? Those guys can use their hands, control the point of attack, shed those blockers, and go get those ball carriers.
Here's second and 10. Shotgun now for Carr. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Tre'Davious White with a pick.
And the Bills are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive.
Play clock down to zero, and this is not the way to start a drive. So that'll back him up five.
Can't hear you. Can't hear you now.
Problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay. And that'll set them back five.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The atmosphere here, electric. No matter the venue, the home folks love their silver and black. They are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with the Cleveland Browns. And we are underway at Allegiant Stadium. Jackson now to return. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, still a good return. They'll start the drive right around the 37. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. First rep of the game for Josh Jacobs. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
That's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And, you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there about to break a big one.
But just play number three here on the opening drive, and it's an early third and one. Trying to run for it with Jacobs. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Third and short, so didn't need much, but got a little extra on the backside. Nice run.
Chewed up the yardage, didn't he? To me, that was offensive line with leverage, good blocking angles, taking on a stacked defensive front. And once they chopped that little hole in the beginning, he took it and rambled.
And just the third play from scrimmage, wanted to avoid the three and out and did just that. On first down, Carr steps away to his left. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
On second and 10, Carr. Eluding the pressure right. Got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Little glimpse of his athleticism there and what they're going to have to deal with. He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And wouldn't you love to get a copy of their defensive scouting report going into the week? Because that's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up. Keep him in the pocket. But it's the first drive of the game and emotions are running high. Someone forgot that, trying to make a big play, and gave up a bigger one instead.
And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10. Working from the gun, it's Carr. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Drake. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. They forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. It's been a seven-play opening drive, and this is third and short.
You're mine.
Now, Carr again. And that is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. Darren Waller there to make the grab. And the Raiders have taken the early lead. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Chubb with a carry on first down. It's not going to yield much, maybe a yard. It's second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Forced out to his left. He'll have a first down past the 40. And finally, down at the 36-yard line. A big play that time on the catch and run.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And Bulldog shedding the tackler that gives him some
get
room.
Off the field.
And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb, 36 yards. And the Browns can grab the lead if they hit the extra point. Well, we've said it many times. He is always a threat to go the distance anytime he's got the ball in his hands. And on this occasion, he did just that.
Well, he's definitely the guy that makes this offense go. And when you're an RB1, running back one, you got to be willing to be patient at times as well. Not every run's going to be the home run we saw there. But once you get that opportunity and that opening, you take full advantage.
So they elect to pass there on the two-point try. Sometimes could prove risky there. It worked out.
Yeah, and I love how you bring up that it can prove risky, because if you get it intercepted and they return it, that's 2 points for the defense, but not on that play.
Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off.
I'm the best in the game. I'm the best in the game.
Middle of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
Well, they certainly came out firing in this one, and while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine that'll be the last shot that they take in this game.
Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10. They fake the handoff. Now Carr. And he takes a shot on the release, as this will be incomplete.
Well, so far on this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
Here's Johnson with a reception. And he is going to have the Raiders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Play action. Now it's Carr. Sliding out of the pocket. Trying to get it to Jackson, and it's intercepted. Picked by Ronnie Harrison, and they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. 8-6 the score after one.
King.
He's not going to get me.
Spoke the mic. Mike spoke up.
Mayfield on first down. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. The corner blitz gets him that time as he goes down for a short loss. 13 yards remaining on second down. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. 43 yards on the ground for him so far.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And this is going to be incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on fourth and seven. From the gun, Mayfield. And he's got the hook up to Landry.
You don't want
nothing. Touchdown, Browns. The touchdown pass, Mayfield to Landry. And the Browns add on to their lead. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. Jackson now to return. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Five yards remain on second down.
Come on, D. Showing it.
Shit. Hey, 734.
From the gun, it's Carr rolling to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. Thrown across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Greg Newsom. And the Brownsons are going to take over at their own 28-yard line.
They exited the pocket trying to improvise. That was a tough throw, and unfortunately, it wound up in the wrong pair of hands.
And Brandon, when you're on the run, sometimes your downfield vision can get skewed just a bit. Now, the beauty of extending a play is sometimes your receivers find their way open, but oftentimes you end up closing down part of the field and bringing those defenders to the ball, and that one was picked off.
And a really good show of force there as he gets through for 4 tough yards. Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6.
My five.
Rip left.
That's going to set him back 5 yards.
Mike 5.
Second down. Here's Chubb again.
And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the Trash Man. His ability to sit through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker.
We remind you in just a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Orlando and our good friend Jonathan Coachman. Coach will run through some of the numbers and the next-gen stats from this first half of football so far.
And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there. That brings up fourth. This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more.
44 is the mic. I'm coming.
Hurry, hurry.
I'm coming.
Alert, alert. Alert, alert.
Watch out.
They're indeed going. It's Mayfield. And this is caught. He hits Landry. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. A give. This is Chubb. There he goes again. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. So simple math here in the first half. They've had 3 drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Yeah, the Browns are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
And the formula there on the 2-point try, they go 5 wide, not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that if someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you because they run out of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
First and 10 here, and you know, if they could just get 3 out of this, there's something about narrowing it to a 2-score game at half that makes it feel like much less of an obstacle.
And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Flush to his right. And he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. Carr and the Raiders following the sack, looking up at a 3rd and long. On play action, it's Carr. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, it's looking like another 3 and out here, and at some point, got to be able to put together a drive to keep your defense from having to go right back out on the field. I feel like things are starting to unravel a little bit, and we're not even at halftime.
So 4th and 15, but the offense is staying out there to go for it.
Four down. Hey, watch 28. Check the hot read. Check 43.
Carr to throw for it on 4th down. Being chased out left. Johnson's got it complete. Touchdown, Raiders. Tyron Johnson in the final seconds of the first half.
And the Raiders are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. That certainly went against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and there's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there. Tip of the cap to them.
Up to the line, Mariota. His guys will go for two here.
Switch. Check hot route. Hot.
Now it's the backup, Mariota. He'll buy some time right. And he is into the end zone. So they get two more on the board here just before halftime. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together. Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. Looking deep downfield. And this is caught right along the sideline.
Oh, that's the way to run it, boy.
Keeping the toes inbounds there. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Anthony Schwartz in the final seconds of the first half. And the Browns would extend their lead here just before halftime. McLaughlin now to add the PAT. And that will make this a 16-point lead.
Makes the score Browns 30, Raiders 14. Chase was hot one to kick off for Cleveland.
So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away. Jackson now to return. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. And the half will begin with a touchback. The Browns drive about to get started. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in the second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Mucked that down.
And down he goes. Brought down a Raider sack. The safety blitz staged to perfection that time as they sack him for a loss of six. Here's Dustin Colquitt now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. Here's Jackson to return. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Raiders will take over now, first and 10. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. And their defense did its job by forcing the punt to start things out. And now, Charles, can the offense get in gear?
I think, partner, you can sense them saying, okay, the first half was theirs, but now let's get the momentum back on our side. We forced a punt. Now let's go downfield and score. If we do that, we'll be set up well for the second half.
Going to run the option right. A very good move, but for a short gain out near the 32. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Mariota now. He's got the hook up here to DeSean Jackson. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Pretty ideal right there. Keep it yourself, get the first down, and get the heck out of bounds.
And knowing him, I believe he's thinking, I'd get a few more yards if I just lower my shoulder. But he also hears that second voice in his head, his head coach, or probably his agent too, saying, get out of bounds, man. Don't do that.
And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll try to run it in, going option right. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. He lost 6 there on the first down play. And that's going to be caught for a Raider touchdown. DeSean Jackson there to make the grab. And the Raiders get a score closer. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Throw. They'll roll him out right. And this is going to be caught. So they do get it. And the 2 points. Now they're back down to a one-score deficit. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. And again, it's Chubb. And not too much going there as he'll get it up to the 23-yard line. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of 1 there.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love the blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
On third down, Mayfield. And he's unable to haul it in, so it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field, and that brings up fourth.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out, got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
Now on fourth down, they throw the deep ball, but it winds up to be incomplete. A surprising move to go for, and predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Raiders with the football now in excellent field position. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
It's a loss of two. Brings up second and 12 at the 25-yard line.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second and 12.
One.
Throwing, Mariota. And Waller taking it in over the middle. So it's a gain of 12 there on the reception. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. And that'll be checked down to Drake. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. Working out of the gun, Mariota. And this is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. DeSean Jackson, his second touchdown of the night. And the Raiders have a chance to tie things up as they trail by two here in the fourth. And now the Raiders will face an important two-point conversion attempt here. Mariota will look to throw, sliding out of the pocket. And he will get into the end zone for two. And this game now tied here in the fourth. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
Play action now. Here's Mayfield. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Sacked by Yannick Ngakoue, the former Maryland Terp.
Well, that time, it looked like he essentially just ran right into the pass rush.
Yeah, partner, I'm not much of an outdoorsman, but the fish jumped right into the net, didn't he? Because you've got to make sure that you're deep enough that you can get around the defensive end, have an angle there. But he couldn't do it because he actually cut that one off. Really nice play coming off the edge.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage excellent there downfield, and it leads to a fourth down. Here's Dustin Colquitt now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Oh, it's a wobbler here. A special teams mistake there, no doubt. Just 26 yards officially on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. And good job of just fighting through one tackle there to pick up about three. Second down coming up.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. A little juke. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
I like what I'm seeing from them here. Tie game in the fourth quarter. They understand the situation. They don't need to be in any rush. Go ahead and huddle up and run your offense. That last completion put them in a nice position to take the lead in this game.
Attack!
And this will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports.
That's it, baby. We're going to work.
So it's Raider football as we get you reset. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. They run the option here on first and 10. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down. To throw, Mariota. He gets it complete to Jackson. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 36. From the gun, it's Drake. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6. Now the Browns will use the first of their 3 timeouts as the clock will stop with 1:06 left to go in the game. Mariota. And this goes out wide for Drake. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8. Here's Mariota. Flushed out right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. I see you nodding your head up and down. It's a very heady decision at this stage of the game. Out of the pocket, nowhere to go. Just get rid of it.
That's a smart play because you're not worried about your completion percentage, and you're also not trying to force it into bad traffic as well. Throw the ball away. Live to fight another down.
Number 28, Mike. He's coming.
Now Mariota. Jackson's got it over the middle. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds left to go. A game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. They'll try to run it in, going option right. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. Mariota rolling to his right. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, Brandon, we see why it's a team game there, because there's a sigh of relief that they just released defensively. If he's able to get that one away, that's likely a touchdown. But instead, that pressure from the front got to him and forced the incompletion.
You're right. He had him open just a split second too late on the release. And that's going to be caught. Touchdown. And they've broken our tie here in the final minute.
I don't know how many more of these my heart can take, my man. I just don't know. Another big touchdown late in the game. They look like they're in control, but still, there's a chance. Block the extra point, go down and score, kick the extra point themselves. They can pull this one out.
Yeah, but also on the sideline that just took the lead, you got to get your defense ready and the special teams unit for the kickoff coming up.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Got to pull everyone together and make sure they're still focused and aren't already celebrating a win.
And the Raiders are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll put it out to the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring, and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out.
Check.
Mayfield to throw. Connects with Peoples Jones. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Well, Charles, this one's going to be hard to digest. You take the lead into the fourth quarter, lose that lead. Maybe they felt like they let this one slip away a little bit.
They will definitely feel like that, because when you have a lead, you talk about doing is finishing and closing a game out. But when you flip it over, how about that? Making the comeback and then finishing the game, sealing it on defense, they will feel jubilant in their locker room.
For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. Celebration time tonight on the Strip as we say so long from Las Vegas.